I'm thinking, me and my emotions.
Well, I'm a writer, and I think I was born to write. I put words together in rhyme and composition, and I read poetry to everybody who would listen. But most people just didn't pay any attention, and I know why. Because at that time, down in Scott, Arkansas, in the South, just to think of a little black girl from the hills of Arkansas becoming a writer, that was just unthought of. I began writing in school. I write in my classroom, and I do a lot of writing. But the teachers then just didn't do a lot of dramatic teaching. And I was sort of on my own, and my mama had 15 children. My mother had four set of twins, and she should have been in history or somewhere. And she just didn't have time to listen to poetry. So I was sometimes the second mother. And finally, the preachers heard something about me, my work. So they came to my mother, and I was picked up every Sunday and put in. My mother would put me on this big bow on my head, and I would go and recite. I would go and recite at the different churches for the rallies and Easter Sunday and all of that. I enjoyed that because I just had to write. That was all. Until now, I don't plan my writing. That's why my book is titled Me and My Emotions, because I can wake up in the middle of the night and a poem is pouring out of me. I was honored with the Black History contest for the city of Detroit. I believe it was 1986. I wrote a poem titled I Won't Give Up My Seat Today, in honor of the great Mrs. Rosa Parks. My favorite poem is Back Down Home. Going back to Arkansas is something I always like to do. And this following poem was written while I sat in the front yard of the old place in Arkansas where I grew up. The old house that I shall always call home. It's a poem of both joy and sorrow. And I hope you all will help me enjoy it. I went back down home last summer. I went back just to reminisce, to let my mind flow back through my childhood and the loved ones that I so dearly miss. There was nothing there, nothing but a rundown shack. I did find an old ball that perhaps I used to bounce, and the sleeve of my dad's old coat still hung on the side of the old smokehouse. On the front porch, there was a frame of an old rocking chair where my mom used to sit and rock me on her knee, sometimes singing softly, "Near My God to Thee." In the corner of the wall, there was an old love letter that I received from my first boyfriend. And cobwebs hung heavy in that corner, but that's where Grandma and Grandpa's picture once had been. And down by that old fishing pond, to that old weeping willow tree, it was just standing there weeping with me. I turned and walked away, reluctant to look back. How could they take my house that was once filled with so much love and laughter and let it become just a common shack? So in my final hour, there's just one request I'll ask, that you will lay me down to sleep somewhere near the front door of that mansion that some folks call a shack. Take me back, down home.
The wind will blow, no one knows the time or space.
There go the money right there, Grandma. You got to dance now, Grandma.
Poem for me?
Yeah.
Let me hear it.
What is it?
I want a poem.
Well, when I told her then the nightfall comes, but she's not getting nothing from the witness. My mind grows tired and my body weak. Body pains and sleep. Oh, sleep just wonderful stand. Only God understands the real value of sleep to man. When we sleep, our mind shuts out. Words, fears, and doubts. A heart and soul in peace, just a sweet, good night's sleep. We're all born, we all will die. But I, for one, never question why. When I go, please don't weep. So I will have escaped into the fire.
Not the joy it should be. With life comes pain. Appointed, and you will be rewarded, and all the world will see. Don't cry for me, but don't shed a tear. The time I share with you will always be, and when
excited to be here with my grandmother, 95 years old. God, she had a regular on me. Give me a kiss.
Give me a kiss.
Give me a kiss.
Give me a kiss.
That's for me and my grandma.